of the Hampton Cable Committee. We stand and vote.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay. Our first thing on the agenda is going to be a reorganization of the committee. So, does anybody want to be...
Make a motion to for Brian as chairman.
I'll second that.
And you could nominate yourself if anybody feels.
I'll nominate Bill Lowney for vice.
I'll second chair. It.
Okay. All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Second one. All right. So pretty much everything stayed the same.
Yep.
Okay. No people, so we're not going to have any public comment. New business, lock for the Hampton Beach community room. Basically, it's a cipher. What is that kind of lock? Is that called?
It's a cipher lock.
Cipher lock. And this is the gentleman that does all the locks for the town?
Yes.
And it's a total of $675. It's basically to secure the room. Because the public is allowed to come in, can have access.
That's the room that's over here where the electronics has all been put.
Right, it's not only just the Channel 22 equipment, it's also the fire department equipment.
So it's not secure now?
It's not secure now, no. So,
have you seen the new studio we put in there?
No.
Yeah, it's basic, but it works, you know. Mm-hmm.
It could be secured, but there's a key lock, and if they're out on a call, nobody's here to give them a key.
Right. So it has to.
So what kind of lock is this?
It's going to be a push button.
Combo.
Combination, yeah.
That way the fire department can get in, we can get in.
Yep.
Everybody can get in without keys. So the total price installed is $675.50. Do I have a motion? Motion by Lee.
I'll second it.
Okay. All in favor of that?
Aye.
Unanimous. Okay. Next on new business is update the policy book for requesting a meeting. This is something, I think, was it you, Paul, that brought this up about...
Fred.
Fred, that's right, Fred. Right. About when somebody wants a meeting, instead of, you know, we have to have notice. We can't have, you know, a day's notice. Even 2 days notice, because we're all volunteers and we all work. So as it is now, is there any, I don't even know if there is any.
There's a policy, but nothing. I think the only thing you have is 2 weeks in advance.
Right.
And it's only on a little portion of the website.
Right. And I think what we want to put on there is who they get in touch with. It should be the chair and the vice chair.
There needs to be a definite
chain.
Routine,
right.
A chain that goes down. Because a lot of times I'll find a meeting on a calendar that I just happen to look at and didn't even realize.
Because nobody, especially you, when you do the smaller meetings down here and stuff, you sometimes don't even know.
As well as cancellations.
That's a courtesy. We'd like to have
that. Well, that needs
That's all part of this.
It's policy for meetings, not only requesting a meeting but canceling a meeting. Sometimes it'll go on the calendar as just canceled. Sometimes it'll come off completely. Sometimes nothing at all happens.
Right.
So
right now there's no way of nobody contacts you guys directly and says.
No, we've had a lot of times where we'll go to the room and sit, and then nobody shows up at 7 without any notice.
My last energy meeting was like that.
Right.
And the last energy meeting may be an exception because there's nobody chairing that horse.
Well, right. I understand that. And I
but still, there should be a vice chair. There should be somebody that...
Somebody who lets you know. But it's happened.
Yeah.
All the meetings that we do, Pete and I do, I try to make sure that the chairman, at least the chairman, has my email address and my cell phone number. Changes, something comes up, just give me a call.
Well, maybe we should comprise a list of.
Send me your ideas, and I'll feed it together.
All right, we can do that.
You guys all have my email, right?
Right. We put it all together. Yeah, it just is something, just so we can not waste.
I've got the original one. I've taken it from the PDF on site and converted to text. Okay. I can start working that.
Right. The next on the agenda is, this is something you were working on again, Paul, downed equipment, restore procedure.
Yeah, I am working on that.
Okay. I just, it's something Paul thought of, that it's just going to be a book that will be in both, we'll put it in both studios, and again, if we put a studio in SA90, which is something on the agenda, that... it'll be there. It'll be just for anybody who comes in and something goes down, instead of calling, not being able to get somebody to help, it'll be a book. We'll have a step-by-step on how to restore the equipment.
We won't do anything too complicated.
Not too complicated. I mean, if it's that bad, yeah. Then we're done anyways. But, I mean, there's always a backup. We can always record the meetings unless we have a catastrophic failure. But even, you know, if it's that, you just have to back, you know.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. Yeah, don't you think?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so I mean, even with myself, I mean, well, with anybody, you don't do it every day, so
right.
I could be taught now, and then a month later,
I
forget, so yeah. I've forgotten how to do it, so I like references, so I that's why you see it on the boards, I have it in my phone, how to redo things, but mm-hmm. I'd like to have it in a book.
No, it makes sense.
Yeah, so anyways, just to bringing that up. Mm-hmm. All right, the next thing is, since we've gotten this increase in the funding, we've talked about this many times, about hiring a part-time media coordinator such as John, as John does in SAU 90. Somebody, I don't know, 20 to 28 hours a week, whatever. Flexible time, if there's nothing to do, you don't come in all day. Somebody retired. Somebody that's, or somebody young, somebody who doesn't mind not working full-time and then benefits are not a problem.
Right. Just so they know that benefits will not be part of this package.
There'll be no benefits,
ever.
Right. No, ever.
Because
Unless, for right now, I mean,
you guys don't want to put any more, you know.
No, you'd never get through the selectmen with any benefits, that's
for
sure.
No, benefits.
Mm-hmm. No. And, I mean, we didn't ask for this windfall, for lack of a better term. All this money that has been thrust upon us, which this poor guy's losing sleep over.
Yeah, well, we're not gonna change a lot. I mean, we've always talked about having this just so we could have somebody to answer the phone and try to improve Channel 22. Right now, it's you know, where we all work. It's really hard, you know, it's hard to do. You know, I come in Thursdays and try to do some things, but you need somebody there all the time.
For you guys that don't know, Brian gets a day off. It's Thursday. 9 times out of 10, he's in the studio.
Well, that's but I just want to...
A lot of people don't even realize that. We all know that. I just wanted you guys to aware of it. Paul is usually probably there with him as well when he can break away from whatever he's doing.
Yeah, but he...
It's just not... I don't think it's right.
Well, it's just if we want to improve the channels, the channel.
Or just do basic maintenance, too.
Basic maintenance, basic, call up and whatever. You just can't do it. You have to do it during the day. You know, it can't be done at night. You can't call somebody for repairs or whatever. And if we have somebody like that, that's flexible. I mean, like I said, it's not a set 28 hours a week or whatever. It's, you know, whatever's needed. And if he's not needed one day, or they can be, it could be a great job for somebody, because if they're not needed, it's a slow week, they just don't have to come in, you know, and they don't get paid for it, so.
That'll include programming.
Programming and everything, yep. They'll be doing everything.
Be nice to have somebody with some knowledge.
Oh, definitely. It'd have to be somebody, it's not somebody I want to.
That's brand new.
Right, that has no clue about it, no.
Right.
No, it'd have to be, that's right. Why, you know.
I mean, I don't think that we're going to be sending them to classes.
No. Not that I can think of, unless it's... Well, there is a lot of... one of our suppliers or vendors is Access AV, and they constantly have vendors' days, but it's always on a, you know, it's during the day. And they have great, they show what's latest and greatest and what can improve, mm-hmm. but again, we can never go. So if we had somebody that can go to that.
Well, you've actually been to classes from them, haven't you?
I've been to one of those vendors nights, and okay. it was when I first got here. Did we? No, just I went. Yeah. And I really was, you know, overwhelmed because it was, you know, I just was here a year and I went and I had no clue what I was looking at. But
I mean, I can see where there would be times if classes were available. Just I'm not sure we'd have to have a line item and a budget for training
because there isn't
one for anybody else.
No, but I mean, it's such as Laytronics, if they had Laytronics training, which I get a lot of...
We don't have the money to be able to do it.
No,
before, really.
No, to have proper training. No, none of us have.
No.
It's all as you go. But that's something I like to bring up to the selectmen.
But what you're going to have to do, you know, is, I mean, you guys all know the need mm-hmm. and understand the need, but you're going to have to present a pretty good...
We will.
Presentation of what the need is and why this should be done.
Right.
You know, I mean, you know, what the need for a part-time person, what the person's going to be doing, how often you think you're going to be needing them, you know, what kinds of things you do now that are beyond what you really should be doing, what...
Right, I mean...
That all has to be spelled out pretty clearly.
Well, the other person that does know is Fred, because a lot of times... Brian is talking to Fred
right.
if there's problems and, you know, like when it was down. Fred was pretty much aware of a lot of the things going on.
Right.
But Fred doesn't vote.
Right now we're in the middle of an upgrade for streaming. Streaming's down. It has been down since I started the upgrade. But my job has pulled me away. I have this. I can't even get to streaming until Thursday.
Right.
Which he is paid by the cable committee. Everybody
right.
should know that. That he is, the cable committee pays yep. his salary when he's doing that. It's not on the
But account. I haven't had time to because of what's going on in the town office. So they're
paying. It's not going to happen. Yeah.
But I mean, that's the type of thing you need
right,
to just.
Right, that has to be brought up.
Bring up and bring up, you know, the
town, this. If the town's happy the way it is, which, you know, it depends how long, you know, we all do a lot. We do all the work. We do all the filming, we do the Christmas parade, we do all that. If we were to leave, I mean, I'm not saying that's what's going to happen, but will the next group want to do that? Maybe not. And they'll say, well, no, we don't want to do it, because it's up to the volunteer to
right.
do it. So, you know, if you have somebody there to maybe go into the schools and try to recruit some young people to get excited about it, and maybe they'll come down, and because we haven't had an intern in... Since Brian Raffon, and he's out of college now, so it's been a
right.
while. It's been 4 years or so. So 4 or 5 years.
Right, but I mean, a good presentation on that. And
yes, you know, I agree.
The needs,
right.
what the needs are.
And what it could help.
What it could help.
It would,
you know, because I think the people voted for the Warren article for a couple of reasons. You know, one is that a lot of people felt it was a tax on people that had cable, and they didn't want that. They didn't think that was fair. I mean,
right.
that... You know, because I mean, a lot of people, what they're saying is, you know, they're taking 75% of that out of the general fund.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
So, and then other people, I think, voted for it. And I think there was another reason people voted for it, because they want that, you know, they appreciate what Channel 22 does. They watch it, and they want it to improve.
Right.
I think more were going towards what you said first
yeah.
than what you said second.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's why you know. That it's important that when you present it that somebody doesn't just say, well, look, you got all that money, now you want to go crazy.
Well, we're not going to...
Yeah,
yeah
I mean, you're
going to
show
happen.
The needs
yeah.
of
well, this
why
has been something
necessary.
That you, oh, we've gone before and have mentioned
well, this is actually...
In 2 or 3 years.
This was approved, I don't know how many years
the
ago.
The coordinator.
The coordinator.
Yeah.
Well, a person
yeah.
up to 20... I forget what it was.
20 hours.
20 hours a week was approved years ago, but we just never have done it. And, we were asked a previous board, and they were totally said no. But it's going to get to the point where now that this money is here, we're going to have requests either from other, you know, for different things. You know, not necessarily for Channel 22, but maybe, you know, the high school. I don't know. We don't know where it's going to go.
Right. There'll be other things
there's
coming.
There's going to be debate, and I can't personally. Stay aware. I can't, take it all in and try to deal with it in my business. So
right.
I think it's opened up a can of worms.
It has. Yeah, it is. And it
has.
It has. And it's not going to change the way we do things. We're not going to blow money. We're not going to spend just to spend. Never have.
It's going to have to be decided on how the money's divvied up.
Right.
I mean, because that would be the selectmen's, how much it's going
to
go. You got X amount right now for 22.
Yeah.
X amount for 13.
Yes.
If somebody does, somebody is going to come up eventually.
They will, yeah.
With public access.
Right.
Now, can we be part of that conversation?
What's that?
As we're the cable advisory committee, can we be part of that conversation?
Sure. I believe so.
Because
right now,
we never are.
Yeah, the control of the money right now is in this, because I went down and talked to Mark today and asked him to research everything, which he's in the process of doing, so we know exactly where we're going with it. And right now, it goes into the fund, and it's at the control of the selectmen.
We just advise. That's all we can do.
But I'm sure the selectmen are willing to listen to all parties, yes.
But I don't mean that we necessarily need charge of the money. We need people that come in that ask for things. We never get advised on anything. It's just basically the selectmen make a decision. We just sit on the sidelines and watch what happens. We're never part of that.
Okay,
Well, the school board, they say U90.
Okay.
And they come in and they request whatever they request. No questions are brought up, to us. What do you think of this? Is this a good idea? Do you have some other recommendations? Because as an advisory board, we're not even...
Right, right. I mean, I hear what you're saying, but I don't know if... Yeah, that would have to be worked out. What I'm trying to say is this an advisory board for 22?
Right.
We
don't
does 13 so fall under 22? I mean, that's what I'm talking about,
Is it
a 13 is separate?
Don't
yeah.
know.
And that's what I think. That's why I asked Mark and I talked to Fred and I said, let's get this worked out.
Right. We have
exactly
to, is,
where
is
we're
this
at.
Is this Hampton Cable Committee or Hampton
yeah.
Channel 22 Committee?
Yeah. Yeah. And that's now for Hampton Cable Committee,
right.
Then yes, you would be, in on everything.
Right.
If it's Channel 2 Advisory Committee,
right. Then we're not.
You're not.
Well, I mean, I believe it's always been the Advisory Committee.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
But there was only one channel.
It wasn't really complicated with the two channels and possibly three and possibly you got Winneconnet High School that
right.
is... Now, looking at Winneconnet, I believe 40% of the students at the high school come from Hampton.
Right.
So, I mean, they could be eligible for 40% of a third, say.
Yeah, right.
If you divided it up equally between the stations and Winneconnet.
Right.
But there's also another avenue that the school board pursued, which is the educational channel. Right now, they're just on another public access channel. There is an avenue for an educational channel that they chose not to use.
What? Within the... I have not seen
the
contract that was signed with the town, so...
If you...
You'd have to explain that to me.
As far as I understand, the way I understand it,
mm-hmm.
that they would... It would encompass all schools in Hampton, meaning Winneconnet.
You have to remember Winneconnet is a different administrative unit.
But it's all schools in Hampton. I don't know how the wording is in the cable contract.
Yeah, that's why, I think that whole discussion with Mark and Fred researching that,
mm-hmm.
I think it's probably a discussion for
yeah,
a different meeting.
They're going to have, either way, we're going to have to, I'm sure there's going to be a need for another channel. I know it's there, it's like Channel 18 or something,
yeah.
but... It's got to be. I think you can't just get it. You have to go and
yep.
negotiate and all
I mean,
that.
I was part of. I filmed a school board meeting when this was all coming up, and there were members there that did not want to have to use the educational channel.
may not want to be with SAU 21.
I'm not saying that. They just said that they would prefer not to use the educational channel. That may have been the reason why.
Oh, okay.
Well, so what would they, I don't understand.
So they took they took channel 13, which is another public access channel, which is like 22.
Not public access, it's government.
Well, I'm sorry. The same as 22, but it was another slot.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, at the beginning.
Technically.
Before all that, it was going to be another governmental channel. Yeah, that was it. Yeah, way
yes,
back.
Yes, we had the hours to prove that we utilized our channel.
Yeah, that's right. Before that, okay. I now I know what you're
doing. But it wasn't designed at the time to be an educational channel.
So would the town want to have two channels and then...
Oh, no.
So repeating the same process.
Yeah, right. I don't think so. I don't think I don't think we'd have...
Well, they would have negotiated their own deal with Comcast in an educational channel to giving them the setup for whatever they needed, like 22 was.
But I don't believe the school department was in on the negotiations.
No, they weren't.
I have a question.
They had no opportunity to
discuss
it.
It was pretty much just, all right, channel, you know, the educational, let's give it to them. That's what happened. It wasn't written down, this is going to be an educational channel. It was just, there was a need, there was a channel, but, you know. And I personally don't think that we could have filled two channels. I mean, I didn't think, I mean, we could just play over and over and over, you know, have one channel continually. Well, that was the plan, was to have one channel continually playing meetings 24 hours a day, and the other one be a live channel plus play meetings. But
is that in other towns? Is that how does the school negotiate with the Comcast with the cable company themselves?
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't think so.
In other towns, in all towns, either the town manager and selectman or the mayor negotiate a contract with Comcast or with Verizon, whatever is in their community. The monies always go through the mayor, the town manager, and the selectman, and then is passed forward to whatever PEG channels are in that community. Some communities choose to have three stations. They'll have public access, educational, and government. Other communities may just have a government channel. It's really,
it's what you want to do.
What you want to do with the monies within your community and what the need is.
Right. It's like public access, and we were our channels are relatively inexpensive. I mean, it's basically you film, it's us, and it's. But when you get the public access, that's when a lot of money is needed. I mean, you're gonna have to have a full time person there at all times while it's open. For training and the equipment's, I think the equipment is a lot more extensive and expensive and complicated. It's just not the same. So, I mean, that's something we have to, I guess we're going to, I don't think it's anything we're going to go look at.
That would really be up to the selectmen to decide if the town needed a public access channel.
Up to the selectmen and up to the people that come forward.
and say we want it.
Enough people.
Mark is well aware also of that conversation.
Okay,
that
I'll talk to him.
I have a question because we're still on the part-time media coordinator.
We did drift.
John, do you have a job description?
I do.
Could we take a peek at that and perhaps come up with one for Channel 22, so that we have obviously it would need to be tweaked.
Mm-hmm.
But we would at least have a job description to go before the Board of Selectmen and say, this is what this person is going to be doing.
I might even have that downstairs. Yeah. Every time you submit a budget to
Superintendent or Nathan usually sends something.
Yeah, right. The same, you know. It's, yeah.
I think if we could, you know, we had that and pass it out and say, this is what this person would be doing.
Right.
Because, you know,
right.
You're a full-time, you own your own business, you can't be here. Doing all
well,
of this.
If the town, and to look into, like, if they do have a need for public access, it's going to have to be somebody like that
right.
that's going to be doing the legwork. Are you year to year? Is that your contract year to year? That's why they always, they like hire you every year. Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Because every year we get the same thing. It's like looking for it. I'm like, oh, John must have moved on, but okay.
All right.
No, I'm year to year. It's 20 to 25 hours. At least contractually, but sometimes I'm there 35 hours. It depends, you know, as you know.
Right.
You end up sometimes staying later than you think that's going to happen. So.
Right. Okay. All right, well, we'll get that together. Well, I'll work on that.
If you don't have that, Ryan, I can get it from,
all right,
from SAU.
I'll let you know. I'll give you an email.
One additional point, I think Jim's point is well taken about making a case for this part-time person, but I've been here like a couple years now, and you've been the chairman a long time.
Yeah.
I think, well, you know, once I learn a little more, maybe I could work my way up to that. But the way things are now, it could never happen because I work Monday through Friday for the town. Bill works Monday through Friday for the town. We don't have that weekday that we can commit.
Right.
So I'm kind of, I think this part-time person would help sort of ensure the future moving forward.
Right.
You know.
Right. Unless, you know,
Well, additionally, you're right, Pete, because what happens if Brian decides, well, I think I want to retire to Florida.
Right.
His knowledge is going to go with him.
Right.
And then we're stuck.
Right.
With, you know,
it would,
there has to be an order that people walk into.
Quite a few years to even, you know, not saying anything like I'm going to get where I can do what I can do now.
Right.
It's just been trial and error, you know, and you'd have to start all over again unless you found somebody, you know, willing to do it that's maybe retired, like, but would have to, I don't know, do, it's just, we're not just an advisory. I mean, we're the workers,
right?
So, which is weird, you know. At most, a lot of places, you like Northampton and such, they have a committee, and then they have
employees.
Yeah. Well, one guy. Yeah. Northampton has John Savastino, who does everything for them, and he has some kids that help him out. So, but we try to do this and also run the meetings and Christmas parades and talent shows and whatever and we
sporting
can.
Sporting events,
which. You know, we all enjoy doing, but it you know, sometimes it's 5 days, 5 nights a week after working every day. So, and not complaining because we don't have to do it. So, but the people like it. So I hate to disappoint. So,
well, I can say just in my experience working in cables companies and peg stations in Massachusetts, they've always had a committee. And they've had a part-time person to take care of government, a person to take care of the educational. They've had a nonprofit group that would run the public access.
Right. It would be a group, right?
Right.
Right.
There's a board, a completely separate board that runs a nonprofit for the public access.
That's what you were talking about, right? Setting up a...
And that's how it's usually done.
Right. Yeah, I think
committee people aren't the ones that are out there doing all the filming and programming. And
no, it just happened to be that way. This
person that's hired part time usually
does that. Yep, because that's I was talking to at one of the games in Manchester. A Manchester guy. I can't. His name was John, and he needed a part. And he needed a battery pack, and luckily I had it in the van, and so because he was. Going to be in trouble without it. He wouldn't be able to film. But I was asking him how they works there, and they actually do the same thing. They only get 25%. But, of course, Manchester, 25% of Manchester, is he was well over almost 400,000, I think he said. So, I mean, that's they're just there 25%. So and that runs two channels, and then they have public access that takes some more money. So, or runs there. No, actually runs just the one channel with that. And you have three employees to do there. But, all right. We'll wait a second. So
I guess what I was saying is I think you certainly can justify a part-time person.
I think so, too. And, but again, we'll put together the best we can and get in front of and try to see if they'll, if you guys will bite, you know. Because I think it'll improve Channel 22. I think it'll be better. You know, we can upgrade. And with that person, I was talking to Fred, and he had some advice that we should bring in. This person should be looking for a expert in the field to come in and look at our equipment, look at our setup, and say, wow, you know, you're doing that pretty good, but, well, this you're not doing too good, you know. And and just tell us what we're doing wrong, you know, because, you know, we, you know, our sound is okay, but it could be better, I think. But I don't have the knowledge. You know, I can go look at stuff or go on B&H and look at all this, but, you know, I don't know. So I would love to get somebody in there that just go through the whole studio, and even to this one, and say, to make this better without spending a ton of money, you need to do this. You need to buy this equipment and not this.
That's a good idea, like an outside audit.
An outside audit, oh my God.
Because Channel 22 started, it was probably, you know, one little camera and one little recorder, and it got built up and built up and built up, and not all the parts necessarily.
And now you have you know, town guys that work at the town, you have a guy who rents equipment, and you have other, you know, that, but we're not in the field.
Right.
You know, we're not professionals to tell us, you know, you are doing it right or you're not. So, and that'd be great. If you come in, you can go in and you wouldn't have any problems with sound problems. Right now, our sound is acceptable, I think, but not, it's touchy. It's very touchy.
It's better than it was.
It's better than it was, but it can, you know, but we've asked Comcast. We've had other sound people in, but it's a different animal than, like, doing a band, you know, on a stage. It's just a whole different animal, and we need somebody who knows it. They couldn't, you know, Comcast could not fix our problem. It was actually Paul that fixed our problem. So.
And there aren't a lot of people around that know what to do.
No, they don't. That's, I mean, we called everybody, and nobody could help. I mean, it was Comcast equipment, and they could not help us. So. All right. So we've kind of burned that out now. The next thing is a studio.
Just stay there. That was already voted on then, all right? You said the part-time, back a few years, you're saying that was never
filled? We should probably, I would like to put it to a vote again, who's in favor of going forward with this, you know, putting together a presentation for the selectmen.
I'll make a motion that we hire a part-time person.
All right.
With a job description to follow.
With no benefits.
No benefits, you know, probably 20-25
flexible hours a week. Yeah, up to a max of, we'll find a max of a month, you know, in the month. So, I mean, if they want to work 40 hours 1 week and not the next week if there's nothing going on type thing.
At what salary would you recommend?
It would be, well, probably $25 an hour, something like that, 20-25. I'd have to...
I would say based on level of experience.
Yeah, I think that would be it, based on level. I mean, if it's a novice or if it's somebody of your profession, then yeah, you know.
I don't see it to go over 25.
No, I don't see that either. Again, we're looking for somebody that's... it's not going to be their primary job, or they're retired, or they're right out of college and they, you know, they live at home. You know, it's going to have to be one of those, and we know that. It's not somebody you're going to make a living on, I don't believe, or...
Right.
So, does anybody have a second on that?
We're going to go back. But should it be to put a presentation to the selectmen?
Right, to put a presentation.
Not to go out and hire, because we don't have the ability to do that. To
put together a presentation selectmen.
Presentation to the selectmen to hire a part-time position on...
For Channel 22.
For Channel 22 with salary based upon experience.
Not to exceed $25 an hour.
Right.
Okay. And Pete second. All in favor?
All in favor?
Aye.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the next thing, this was another thing that was recommended to me, and I think it's a good idea, is a studio for SAU 90. And I actually talked to, it was funny, Dave O'Connor came in, and I said, Dave, is there any place you can put a studio? I know that the school got... you know, voted down this year. I don't know when it's going to be up again. I don't know. But I think a studio for the junior high, I mean, there was talk of putting it in the center school, but I just don't know. I think it would be great to have it where the kids could use it.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay, good. And I think they could make it so... you know, like this, it could be taken down. I mean, once, if your construction's going and well, that this room's going to be demoed. It can be taken out fairly easy and then put back somewhere else. But I don't know. What are your thoughts on that?
I spoke to the superintendent yesterday because David told me he had spoken to you, Brian. And I think she would like some time to brainstorm a little bit to see what kind of equipment we'd be looking at that would match the equipment we already have.
Right.
Something that's not necessarily fixed like these particular cameras, but something that's portable. She's thinking about eventually doing school board meetings there to take it out of your hands, which I'm sure you'd be happy to do.
Right, well,
And a lot of the budget meetings could be held there, as well as the kids. I don't know if you've seen the Shark News that the kids are doing now. It's fabulous.
Yeah,
you go on YouTube, you can get it.
I did try looking for it, but I didn't find it.
Paul, if you check YouTube under Shark News, you'll be able to pick up some of they're doing a great job. And I mean, they got kids doing weather, they got green screens going.
Right.
Awesome job. But I know the superintendent would like some time to
sit down
with several people and a couple of consultants to see what we could put together and probably make a proposal to the committee as well as the selectmen.
Right.
But definitely there is a need for a studio.
That sounds a little more more than what you had planned on, as far as you said, if something's going to get moved, it's easy enough to break down.
Well, that's what they want. Looking at portable cameras.
Compared to what we have in the, when you see that, you'll see what we have for here.
Right. I know it's great to have these types of cameras because you can get one person in there and you got to control it for multiple cameras and switching.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to look at it also that it's a learning experience for the kids. We want kids to have hands-on. To have individual cameras as well as maybe having a technical director and
right,
and then hopefully move on to Channel 22.
Come on and move on to volunteer
as interns,
as well as looking forward to being able to move that equipment to when the new renovation gets approved by the voters.
Yeah, it sounds like a plan. Okay. All right, well, that was just, I'm glad she's looking into it, and Dave was brought it up. So, yeah, just let us know, Okay, well, we've been talking about the future of Channel 22 and 13 with the passing of the article. I guess we've been basically talking about it now. So, it is getting a studio over there. It is maybe get a media another part-time guy for Channel 22. It's possibly public access. I mean, it's a lot of things. But for right now, I mean, I think I would like the people to know that since we have this money, it's not like we're going to spend it all. It might build up in there. You may see a lot of money in that account, and it's just because there's no need to spend it. I don't see a reason if you have it to spend it. If it's needed elsewhere and it has to be taken out by a warrant article or something, that's what happens.
That's why I said, this, we didn't ask for this.
No, we didn't. And we're gonna be responsible, and we're not gonna be kids in a candy store. So
yeah, I think the important thing though, Brian, is just to make sure that you have future plans. Because as you know, what happens with sometimes when funds start to build up, people, so they don't need that.
Right. But that would be something
You come up with plans for the future. Right. Like what you said, the future of 22 and 13, where is it going to expand to? What's eventually going to happen? Right. What's it eventually going to cover? What could the potential be? So even though you're letting the money's building up,
right,
but it's building up for a purpose.
It is. And we can't give you an answer right now what it's going to be we have to do some research.
Right.
We have to, we never had this.
Yeah.
Problem, this not a problem, but this situation before,
right.
We never thought we would. We're always kind of getting by.
Yeah.
So,
well, we were able to build up enough, for instance, to buy the van.
To buy
some different cameras, but we never, envisioned this.
Yeah.
Having somebody. We'll take care of these things instead of us trying to do it.
It was always on a wish list, but we never thought it would ever come true.
Right. And again, we'll have to see what the public wants. We'll have to see what comes down the corridor. If they want what they want. They want more, they want less, they want public access. You know, we'll have to see what happens. That's all we can do. Anything else on that?
I think we about beat that horse to death.
Yeah, we have.
Snake.
Is there any other new business anybody can think of?
I have something.
Sure.
And I want to put this to the board and see what your thoughts all are. I was thinking, do you think that Channel 22 could benefit from a little bit of a social media presence?
That's right, you were talking about that. You mean like on Facebook or something?
Yeah, like a Facebook, a Twitter. I kind of just thought maybe if every Monday you just send something out there reminding people the selectmen's meeting's on. And
that's
hit
not
some
a bad idea. I don't know whether, is that legal? Is
no,
legal?
I wasn't
it's
sure.
Fine. That's it's a great idea.
Well, that's something that
and we can get in person
also. Could do as
it's
well.
Cheap. It doesn't really cost anything.
Yeah.
And I feel like our average viewer's a little on the older side.
Yeah.
Maybe we could outreach a little bit.
Right.
To some younger viewers. I mean, we don't really know.
And we can have links from the
who's town. Watching. We only have those.
Maybe we could have. I wonder who could set that up for us.
I can set up the Facebook page for
oh,
you
okay.
as long as I.
Make sure you set it up as a group versus an individual.
Correct.
Well, that would be great. Because I don't know how to do it, so.
And but what I would, excuse me, if you want to check with Christina, is that her name? Just to make sure that we're not stepping on anybody's toes. Because I know, like, PowerPoint needs to go through her before it gets on there.
That'll still have to be the same, yeah. She still has to look at everything.
And we'll just have to, as a admin, I can watch it for a while and delete, you know, things that we don't want on there.
Right.
Negative or bad comments or whatever.
Yeah.
And then when the new person come in, they would need to do that.
Right.
But it would be a good reminder, which leads me into my other old business, to try to get Community Corner up and running. We only had one show.
Well, we actually had two. I actually did one.
Did you?
I did because it was during the day and it was
okay.
And I put it under that title.
Okay.
It was the same thing. It was about the Lions Club.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'd like to get that going.
I would
and
like
again,
to have
this is a way to, like you say,
more.
Get people to see that, oh, there is
sure.
There
like
is
the
there.
Recreation groups, younger kids coming in, maybe telling them
sure.
what they're doing. You know?
You could definitely get that message out on Facebook, that's for sure. You know, something like that.
I think so. Yeah. I think it's a great idea. I think we, you know, and again, the only.
I don't know about Twitter.
I don't know that either.
I think there's a way you can like link them both up together. So if you put it out on one, it goes out on both, maybe.
I can find out.
Yeah.
We have a good marketing group at my work. Yeah. I can ask them how you do all that stuff.
That sounds great. Yeah. I think that's a really good idea.
So there will be one advertisement. It's going to be from Favorite Foods. Don't be surprised.
No, I would not do that. I know the rules.
So Community Corner covers what?
It basically what happens in the community, it covers nonprofits. Well, was it nonprofit? Yeah, like Experience Hampton. The only ones we've done is Lions Club, Experience Hampton. Anybody else who wants to do one to recognize their nonprofit group and want to talk about it, just get a hold of
me for the Community Corner part.
Yeah, Lee Lowney. What's your?
It's llowney@favoritefoods.com.
And talk to her, and we can set up a time, even on a Saturday. I mean, we can do a Saturday.
Traditionally, that's when I would do
right.
Right, because
we got to work every day.
Right.
You know?
So, I know that the Hampton Youth Association wanted to do something.
Right.
And what they really were looking for was the PowerPoint at that point.
Right.
Because they said it was happening on March 8th, and I said, oh, I don't. It was March 6th or something. So I don't think I can get somebody to film that, but he said maybe after that they would have the chairman of that group come in. It's a nonprofit. You know, as long as we stay within our boundaries of what we need to do, I think it's a great idea to get groups together. And,
yeah.
And you know, with the Experience Hampton, when we talked about the walkway that, you know, that was put in and, you know, we can talk about whatever as long as it's not going to make a buck for anybody.
Right,
so.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think the Health and Human Services groups that, you know, put forth on that Warren article every year would be good, too, to reach out to them to see if they want to.
Right, or even new ones, new people who
new
want
ones?
To. Yeah,
right.
New groups that want to maybe get a piece of, you know, some of that tax money that we that town gives to those organizations. So.
They are no longer required to come in unless they're new. Is that correct? In front of the selectmen, we have a group that we do just traditionally.
New, and they're supposed to give a report of what happened.
A report.
They don't have to come
in.
A report. We should get a report from them.
But it would be, like you said, Pete, it would be nice if they wanted to expand on that and say, this is what we're doing right now in the town of, you know, what you're getting.
This is what you're getting for
you know, would be a great idea. If they want to do that, you know, shoot me an email, we'll set it up.
Yeah. And we can work nights. We can do a lot of things.
The only other thing, and this is about spending money, but is there any way that we can get some different scaffolding?
Oh, than that? Oh, for doing the... We could. Now we could. I mean, I donate that from the store, so it's pretty cheap. Yeah, something that doesn't shake.
Yeah, when you're up filming, you know, however many feet I was up there.
Yeah, that was.
And, I mean, we don't have the young people on our crew. We have
one young guy, yeah.
So that was scary climbing up there.
I know. Well, I'll look into see what kind of something
that awesome can be. Job, though.
Because we do use it for flag football and such, so. I'll look into that. I'll look into that. You know, more a stable stadium, but it can't be too much wider. That's the problem, because it'll be in the way. Okay, is there anything else? So is there any other new business? Anything you got, John? Or
you know?
No, I think we're...
I may make a premature motion based on what we've had happen here. That I wanted to make a motion that we were going to discontinue filming the school board meetings anymore.
Yeah, well, I know you'd mentioned that. Right now, until they get their studio, it would be kind of...
It would be very difficult.
It would be very difficult to do that.
Well, I used to film them in the library of the Marston School with John Nickerson for years.
Yeah.
Around cart. That's what we used.
I know. I understand where you're coming from, but...
I hate to say it, but I feel like they're double dipping. They're not only taking the money, but they're also having us do the work to film the meeting.
Right, but that's... It's only... I think it's coming to where we get the studio, which I think will be done, I think, within a year or so, don't you? Or
hopefully.
Sooner than that.
Hopefully by the fall. The end of October or early November.
Right. I think
squared away,
and I talked to Craig and I talked to Nick, and they don't mind doing it. So I just don't want to, with the money we've gotten, this new money, I can't see how we can justify not doing it.
Well, it should be one or the other. I mean,
I know. I understand. I know. I understand. I know, Bill. I know. Yeah. I know. But it is the school.
Mm-hmm.
It is a town school. I know it's their own channel, but that would be asking a lot. I mean, it's basically John. That's it. So, I mean, he works days, and then he'd have to...
Mm-hmm.
And he does all the other budget meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so...
Yeah, no, eventually I see that, you know, we should definitely take over the school board meetings. Absolutely.
Right. But I
agree with Bill, but I think right now, given the equipment and the personnel... I'm covering three schools. I'm covering concerts at night, and
I think it'd be the magnanimous thing to just keep going the way we are. I don't know if that's the right word, but just keep going the way we are until they get there. And I think we're gonna get this approved. This studio. I don't see why we wouldn't.
Yeah, I think
with the funding that we have now. And then
it'll be self-sufficient eventually,
right,
with all the monies that are available to both channels. So
yeah. So I think for right now, I just would hate to cut them off right now. I mean, if it was a money issue and we were down to...
Well, you wouldn't actually be cutting them off. Well, there'd be a new way of filming their meetings.
Yeah, but it'd be... I mean, it's once a month. I just don't want to... I mean, if it was you doing it and you didn't want to do it, then I can understand. But, I mean, I've got... I've asked those two if they mind. If it's bothering, they don't mind. They're there. You know, it's a night a week. It's a night a month. And in fact, they didn't even do it this month. I think they had it at the...
They did have it at the library.
The library, right.
The new people, but...
Right.
I mean, if worse came to worse and you don't have somebody...
If that'd be... Yeah.
Train me over there and I'll come... Because right now, to move everybody out of there is, I think, is...
Yeah,
it's not going to work.
It's also not.
I'd be happy to go down and cover the meeting myself.
I know you would. And the thing is, they don't have a projector. They don't have any of that, which they use almost every meeting, for a PowerPoint or such.
Yeah.
So that would be difficult. And I've seen the ones down there, and it's because my wife was on the board years ago, mm-hmm. and it's a tough angle because you're basically going right down the. You got one camera going right down the. Down the table, so it's hard to go back and forth. So I mean, as long as it's a free night, and we got people for right now. I mean, it's possibly another 6-7 meetings, and that's it. And we'll have this other studio up, and then we can even work if the guys want to work there. You know, if you can't make the night, you know, whatever. We just got to make it work. I mean, it's a lot of money we got to deal with, or not deal with. And I just, I mean, we can take a vote on it. I have no problem with that.
Mm-hmm. You take a vote or withdraw. You want to do it.
It's up to you. I mean, if you want to take a vote, make a motion, that's fine.
I'm going to make a motion that we discontinue filming the school board meetings.
Okay, do I have a second?
I'll second the motion for discussion.
All right. Well, let's talk more about it.
I mean, I see where Bill's coming from. Yeah. Channel 13's up and running. You think they should be filming the school board meetings. But with this renovation project kind of on the cusp, I do think something's going to happen there. And if we delay a year, like you said, at most it's just 12 more meetings to do, probably.
Right.
So I think we could wait a year and revisit it in a year's
time. I agree. If they get the studio and then they don't want to do that, that's a whole different thing.
You know, I don't even think it'll be a year. I think
I don't either.
I think once the equipment is in, then let's say we put out a list of what we feel our needs are, and the superintendent is happy with it. We get stuff in.
Right.
A couple days.
I would say by the end of October, early November. Would be able to be up and running.
I guess when I said a year, I was thinking more about the whole renovation project, like happening at the school. But
okay.
You're talking about getting something going even prior to that.
Even prior to that, because
who knows how long until I don't. Are you gonna, I don't know what they're doing.
Who knows how long the renovation project.
Right.
I think it took 5 years to get the police station passed.
Right. Right.
It took 100 years for a fire station.
Right. 100 years for a fire station.
Oh, goodness. We won't even be around. We won't even need to worry about it.
You know, hopefully, next year's the voters will approve the renovation, but then you're still looking another year. So you're looking 2 years down the road.
Yeah.
Right. I'd say,
So do you have a place in mind currently?
I do. In fact, we've scoped out... looking at the stage in the academy cafeteria, there's a little area behind that could be cordoned off for a control room.
And then use the cafeteria?
And use the cafeteria to set up chairs, and they can set up, you wouldn't have anything permanent like the desks here, but they could set up tables.
And you think
custodians
about it,
takes them 20 minutes to put up the chairs.
And that would actually, if we had the budget meeting there, it would benefit us if we could use that.
And definitely. Have the budget meeting.
All we have to do is go in there.
You don't have to go over to Winnicunnet. And, we could do the meetings there. It would save you guys from doing it, as I said.
Well, I mean, that and also the budget committee has their public,
Public hearing.
Right.
There, and we don't have to come and set all that equipment up two or 3 hours before. Just basically go in and turn on the cameras.
And do we still need to pay Winnicunnet when we have meetings there?
The town does.
Right, that's what I mean.
Yeah,
so
the town pays.
Because of the fact that it's the SAU 21. If it was in HAGH, we wouldn't be paying.
I don't know.
To have meetings there. Is that correct?
The school board, SAU 90 could, because that is basically their property. So they could, but I don't think they do.
That's true. I think we have to cover their overtime for the janitors.
The janitors and such.
Okay, so.
It was seconded.
Yeah.
Any more discussion on it?
Do they have their meetings in the summer? Like June, July, August?
They may have an emergency meeting,
maybe,
but usually.
Maybe one, so you've.
Usually not.
Yeah, so that's 3 more months off.
She got a motion, a second. Yeah. All those in favor?
Yeah, all those in favor.
All those opposed?
Okay, so the other, any other new business? Well, that's it. Old business. I was going to ask you about the shirts, Bill.
Yes. I have the guy's name and number.
The guy, your friend. He's your friend, whatever.
He's the one that gets us from work.
And he gets them.
Not the town doesn't get them, but we buy our own sweatshirts and stuff.
Right, and it's pretty inexpensive, too, right? Yeah. All right. So I was wondering if you can get we'll have to get a list together because we haven't bought shirts in 2 or 3 years, and I know Nick doesn't have any. And
Pete's running off one that
I gave him.
John Wilkerson bought that.
I have John Wilkerson's coat too. So
yeah. No, I gave you that.
Right.
But before that, before the 375th. So that was a while ago. So yeah, we should get a shirt order at least. So if you could do that, I'd appreciate it.
I have all the information. I was just waiting.
All right. To let's get
what you need, what sizes.
Right.
I got to get the logo. I told you it's a one-time fee.
That's fine. But he is a lot cheaper than
$75 one-time fee to set it up.
Well, that's not bad.
What do you put? What do you do? Like polo shirts or?
Well, yeah, polo shirts.
They have a huge catalog. It's like a JCPenney. They got everything you could ever want.
It's a lot cheaper than all your
coffee cups, travel bags, hats.
Yeah. Goes on. Mm-hmm.
What's the company? Do you know?
It's a guy that uses it's one of the catalogs that most of them use.
Right, it's like a vendor, and he's the printer.
Okay.
And,
he's kind of like the middleman. But you just say, I like this Hanes long sleeve T-shirt, page, color, size.
Right, because there's different qualities. So, I mean, these sweatshirts were expensive, and we heard about that. So. We can get, but I mean, they've lasted 3 years too. So,
right. I mean, you definitely get what you
get
for.
What you pay for. I mean, we could get, and we used to get it from Land's End, and I thought, I don't know if that's expensive or not, but John used to get it from Land's End.
Good quality stuff.
It's good quality stuff.
It's comparable to L.L. Bean,
right?
Actually.
But it's also pricey. So we'll have to look into that. Well, we'll have to get a list together and see what it costs, and go before the selectmen and ask them if we can get that to fly. We haven't bought anything in years, so we just basically bought sweatshirts. We have no shirts. I mean, you either wear this or you don't wear anything. So, we have stuff that John bought years ago, but it's
right.
It doesn't fit me, so unfortunately.
Yep, that's fine.
At least we need a tent guy. So, all right, great. The other thing is, I just thought of this Thursday. Is our we talked about our headsets, our wireless headsets. And I was talking to Access AV, and the ones we have are like top of the line, and they are good, but they're held together by duct tape. I mean, we've got to wire them so they work and everything. I did send them back to them, but they did it themselves, try to fix them, and they didn't. They didn't fix them. So I'd like to look into, I'm just going to look into what new ones cost, not the base unit, because that's very expensive, but new packs, and or repair these. I got to find a repair center or something because it didn't work out going to Access AV. Because the guy, I like Mike up there, and he helps out a lot. But is he attacked for these? I don't know because they came back the same way. So that's something we'll bring up, and I'll get some prices on that for the next meeting. Either replacing them, not the base unit, because that's fine. And we have 2 good packs, but the other 2, one doesn't work, and the other one you have to tape it up to get it to work. That's about it. Any other old business? Anyone? No? All right.
Will you ask for an appointment for next Monday with the selectman just to kind of give an update?
Sure.
You don't have to give anything real specifics, but just...
Right.
That you know, the advisory committee met, the things you're thinking about, that
you're
obviously aware of what's happening and you want to keep things moving.
Mm-hmm. We can do that. I'll call, I'll get a hold of Christine.
This is our first televised meeting.
Okay.
Well, they had one years ago. I think this was like one. But this was important. I mean, usually our meetings are very short, to the point. You know, we need to get this, we need to get that. But this was because we've come into all this, the funding has increased three times. You know, we want people to know that, you know, it's not going to be wasted. And we're going to do our best to improve, but not to waste money. That's all I can say.
And I think you've done a great job at doing it.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Is there any other comments?
So I think for our next meeting, are we thinking about coming up with ideas that might be for the future to discuss those sorts of things?
Sure. Anything you think of, you know.
Because I think what you were saying about having future plans is important.
It is. We have to have a plan. We have to have, you know, plans. There's a lot to do. We have to put together a list of our equipment, which we do have, but the turnover of this equipment, okay, now it's 5 years. What do we get rid of? You know, every year, what do we update to keep it from breaking?
Yeah.
You know? And we found that out when it broke. And we have backup for everything. But we should have a plan. And, you know, this has got to be replaced. This has got to be replaced or updated or you know, can it be refurbished like the, you know, the Waytronic. So, and, you know, we got that spare one. Just so you know, we did get a spare one.
Right. You got one on the internet.
On the internet, and it's almost the identical year as the one we have. And of course, we know sooner. It didn't sit on the shelf a week.
No,
ours,
2 days.
2 days, and ours went down.
Went down, yeah.
And we sent it out, and the motherboard, everything went on it, right?
Yeah, the SD card, the motherboard, and the power supply.
So it died. And this is the one we originally sent, and they said there was nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
Well, they said it wasn't figured out or whatever, but I knew there was.
So did they rebuild that?
Yeah.
They rebuilt it, sent it back. We got it back last week.
Yeah, and that was under warranty.
Okay.
So that didn't cost as well. We had to ship it, but yeah. But now we, you know, but we kept going. That would have been a week. We'd have been a week out for that, because it was
probably two.
Two. Yeah, it'd have been bad. I would not want to be here. So, but. So, anything else? Any other comments? All right. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor? Thank you.